as a person which shaitan urinated in his ears. The shaitan pees in his ears. So, dear brothers and sisters, the willpower of ourself and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you try to talk about, we cannot, finish. Let's say their himma al-aliya fi talab al-ilm. How they used to seek a knowledge. The knowledge shar'i, knowledge, the Islamic knowledge. That's what we are talking about. That's what we are giving the priority. The other knowledge is you are doing for your, for the sake of your financial, this, that, the other. But what we are talking is the knowledge of the sharia that you are seeking for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Abbas, example, he was a young man. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was passed away, he was just a young man, just at that time, he was the age of puberty. He came one Sahabi, Ansari, he told him, let's go to the Sahaba of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam and seek knowledge and ask them. And that Sahabi said, you see, do you think people will need you? He was telling that Abdullah ibn Abbas, why are you trying to seek knowledge? Everywhere there is a Sahabi. People won't need you. Just stay, you are a young man, forget about that. But Abdullah ibn Abbas, he has a strong iman and a strong willpower. And he left that person. He says, okay, stay away from me. And he went trying to seek knowledge. And someone pointed him, that Shaykh, a Sahabi, has some hadith from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So go and get. Abdullah ibn Abbas, he went to the house of that Shaykh, and he find out the Shaykh is sleeping, and he's not available at that time. And his door is locked. What he did? Did he just left or turned back? No. What he did was he just tried to wait that person until he wakes up and he slept in front of the door of that person. All night, waiting to wake up that person to just get one hadith. Then when the person wakes up and he comes out, he finds out that Abdullah ibn Abbas is sleeping on the ground in front of his door on the earth. The wind is blowing, cold, dirty, Mention it. Then he said, يَا ابْنَ عَمِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَلَا أَرْسَلْتَ إِلَيَّ فَآتِيكَ يَا ابْنَ عَمِّ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ Why you don't send a message to me so that I can come to your house and give you that hadith and knowledge? Abdullah ibn Abbas, he answered, أَنَا أَحَقُّ أَنْ آتِيكَ فَأَسْأَلَكَ I'd rather come to you and ask you that hadith instead of you coming to me. Because you have the knowledge and I have to seek that knowledge and I have to come to you. That was Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu arda said. Okay. Urwata ibn Zubayr is a young man also. One of the young Sahabas. He was like 12 years or 10 years when the Prophet ﷺ passed away, even younger. But all these Sahaba, these young people, they have a very strong willpower and they very, very strong iman. Urwa, he said, when he was 15 years old, he said, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, before she passed away, Aisha was his aunt. Because Asma bint Abi Bakr and Aisha bint Abi Bakr, both are sisters. He said before Aisha passed away, 4 years before she passed away, I collected each and every hadith that she has it. You see, I collected each and every hadith that she heard from the Prophet ﷺ. All I have it. That he is saying that I have all the knowledge that Aisha has it. And she passed it away while I have all her knowledge. That's what he's saying. He's showing that the strong willpower, right? Amr ibn Qais at-Tamimi. He used to recite the Quran to the people. I mean, an-nas ya'tunian. People used to come to him and he used to recite them and teach them the Quran whole day. From Fajr all the way to Dhuhr. And he used to stay in the masjid until Asr. And also he used to stay in the masjid until Maghrib. And he used to stay in the masjid, you know, until Isha. And then he used to go nisful layl to his home and used to eat a little food just, you know, to sleep just 2 or 3 hours to get his body stronger. Then he used to wake up and stay in Salatul Layl until the Fajr. All this he is doing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to gain the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is not doing this thing for the sake of or gaining, I mean, something for the dunya, for this world, something worldly. He's not doing for this. He's doing for this. This is for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is seeking the rahmah and forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, here is Sa'id ibn Abdul Aziz at-Tanuhi. He said, كنت أجلس بالغذوات لابن أبي مالك وأجلس بعد الظهر وإسماعيل ابن عبيد بعد العصر وبعد العصر حتى إلا المغرب محكول. This young man, he is saying that I used to seek knowledge and I used to sit all these ulama. بعد العصر he is going to one class, بعد المغرب another class, بعد العشاء another class. He used to go around all the mashayikhs, in between all the mashayikhs. And here is Imam Malik rahmatullahi alayhi, قل أن يصلي الصبح بوضوء جديد وإنما كان يصلي بوضوء العشاء 49 سنة. See this Imam Jalil Malik radiallahu ta'ala anhu arda, one of the 4 Imams, Imam Malik rahmatullahi alayhi. It was very rare to pray a new wudu for the Salat al-Subh. Why? Because he used to awake from Isha whole night till in the morning for 49 years. 49 years he was doing this. These people, we are mentioning their names now. How many years? They passed away more than 1400 years or 1300 years or 1100 years. Why their names are mentioning now? Why are we seeking their knowledge now? All this is because they used to have a willpower and a strong iman. That shows you, you know, how they fulfill all this noble task. إمام البخاري رحمة الله عليه يستيقظ 20 مرة في الليل. He used to wake up 20 times a night. You know, one night, whole month. Every night he used to wake up 20 times. Why? ليسجل ما يخطر له. To write it down, whatever comes his mind. I mean, he was sleeping it. Maybe 15 minutes, he used to wake up and he was just asking himself, did you remember any hadith, anything? Just whenever comes his mind, then he used to write it down. Then he put it down and then he used to sleep. You see, now his book is the Asahhu Kitab Ba'da Kitab Allah Ta'ala. Imam al-Bukhari rahmatullahi alayhi. هذه هي الهمم العاليه